John Becker's Symphonia Brevis, will be one of the hitherto unrecorded contemporary works new to the repertories of leading symphony orchestras in the United States and Canada to be recorded on tape as part of the Recording Guarantee Project of the American International Music Fund, of which Mrs. Kuzubitsky is president. The tapes of these performances will be placed in the archives of 6 different depository libraries strategically located throughout the country, where they'll be made available for audition by conductors and other musicians who may aid in the promoting of further performances of these works. This project, according to Mrs. Kuzubitsky, is assured through the participation of more than 20 principal American orchestras and their conductors, through approval of the American Federation of Musicians and the local musicians' unions, and by a renewed grant from the Rockefeller Foundation. The name John Becker may not be familiar at all to those not living in the Midwestern section of the country, because it's there his musical activities have been centered. He has had important teaching positions, but he retired a few years ago and now makes his home in Wilmette, Illinois. The Symphony No. 3, or Symphonia Brevis, as the composer calls it, was completed in 1929, but tonight marks the broadcast premiere of the work as a whole. As a preface to the score, the composer has written these words: "This symphony was written with an outraged spirit. It is not intended to be beautiful in the sentimental sense. It is a protest against intolerance, prejudice, pretense, and sham. A protest against would-be humanitarians who talk much and do nothing. A protest against a world civilization which starves its millions in peacetime and destroys these same millions in wartime." I think you may get an idea of what kind of music Mr. Becker has planned in this Symphonia Brevis. Leonard Bernstein is about to return on the stage here in Carnegie Hall, and this evening's Philharmonic concert will continue with a performance of the Symphony No. 3, Symphonia Brevis, by John Becker.